available anymore. So delete me, please. You spoofed that packet, bomb, route gone. Okay. You can resend your own router advertisement just to be sure that you're sure you get all the traffic because you are then the default router. But you can also omit that, not send your own default router. Yeah, how you can spoof it so that this router doesn't see that is another topic. We're getting back to that. But if you kill all routers, so you're not sending your own router advertisement, the clients will think everything is local. That's what is defined in the standard. If a system has IPv6 connectivity but knows of no router whatsoever, it assumes everything is local. The whole global IPv6 internet is local. Okay, works for me. More stuff. Send a router advertisement and systems become dual stack. So if there's no router advertisement or you don't activate manually, so this is my IPv6 address, the system thinks I only have IPv4 and only uses IPv4, if you don't have Teredo or whatsoever there. But once there's a router advertisement, all systems which are in default configuration become dual stack. You can port scan on IPv6. And if you don't have the Windows firewall, but you use, for example, whatever commercial one, some of the commercial ones don't filter IPv6, but just allow it through. So, full port access, so full port scanning on the local network, just by sending one router advertisement. They will prefer IPv6. Yeah? So if you use a tunnel, so you announce yourself as a router, you say IPv6 is on the network, they will start using IPv6, you tunnel to the real internet, and you have a man-in-the-middle attack. Especially interesting if you're announcing remote network addresses local, let's say for PayPal or whatsoever, yeah, and now that network prefix and every system thinks, oh, this is a local system. So you see how much stuff you can do there. Unbelievable. Router advertisement flooding. I wrote a tool to see what happens if I just send 1 million router advertisers coming from seemingly different routers. What could possibly happen? I mean, that's such an obvious attack, sending random router advertisements, nothing should really happen. That's what I expected. Except if you're a Cisco or a Microsoft, then this might come to you as a surprise. So what happens if you have a Cisco firewall or any iOS or any Windows system, 2008, 7 or Vista, or 2003 or XP if you enable IPv6, denial of service. 100% CPU, no activity possible anymore. Just by sending some router advertisement flooding the network. And some old Linux, but of course fixed long ago. Come on. Cisco just fixed that. Yeah, so these are the fixed numbers for iOS, for ASA. They should be out already, but I don't know the numbers at the moment. Microsoft wrote me a very nice letter and said, yeah, interesting, but this is a design issue. Sorry, we don't deal with design issues. So, I know some, well, this is the emergency response team, and of course, they have no power, they can only tell people, please do, and then some other management say, no, sorry. Maybe in some service packs, but that's what I got about some private channels back, maybe in some service pack, maybe, because doing something like no more than 100 router advertisement in routing table, this is kind of too hard to do, maybe. So they told me, please put some more pressure on the topic and then maybe this will get fixed. So, and by the way, even Apple got this right. This is a command, this is part of the IPv6 tool package. This is the command line which you should not use. Because every Windows system, firewalled or not, doesn't matter. Doesn't matter if you have Microsoft firewall or like me, I have a semantic firewall. Doesn't matter, it's no protection. Yeah? Denial of service, nothing possible. So don't do this here on the local networks. Yeah? Please. We are nice people. We're just pointing the fingers. Yeah? Someone else is pushing the button, maybe. Okay. A completely different topic. So please understand, I can only talk about 60-70% of the stuff I found, I researched and stuff, because it's just too much. I wanted to get at least a little bit of a red line through my talk, which is, agreed, very difficult. I don't know if you see one. Maybe there is none, but remote alive scans, which means what are systems available on a remote network, will not be possible to do ping scans because the address space is just so large. Remember, /64, 4 billion times the whole internet. So it's not possible to do remote ping scans. Some jerk said that, actually it was me 5 years ago, if those few people remember. But then this year I thought about, is this actually true? And I started to do some statistical research. How do we identify remote systems? We can't scan the whole range, obviously. Yeah? If we would do that, if we say we have more than 1 million time gigabit Ethernet connection, and we can send such a big amount of packets, and the people can actually respond to that, and the router infrastructure is supporting it, blah, 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 would still take something like 5,100 years. That's, of course, not feasible. We don't have broadcast, so not something like ping, remote broadcast address, and some systems will answer. We don't have that either. We have search engine and databases, so we can Google for IPv6 addresses, maybe. We have DNS, where we can explicitly ask for IPv6 addresses, like www.google.com. Give me the IPv6 address. There's none, because it has a special IP address, but this is how it would work. And you have common addresses. So, and I'm combining these two to get a pretty good view on what is really there. Of course, there are lots of black spots in my approach. Because what I will show you what I did, I ran through all the DNS entries, I scanned through all the networks, so I really created lots of packets on the network. But I'm, of course, missing stuff. For example, like DSL connections. Asia has lots of IPv6 DSL connections. These are not in this statistical analysis. Other stuff, like routers in between. There is stuff I could do there, but that was not my focus. My focus was more on server side. So this is what the statistic is more oriented to. So, search engines. I dumped various IPv6 directories in there. Quite a few from them. So I got 17,000 possible domains and subdomains identified, just dumping all the database search engine stuff. Then I did some DNS enumeration. For all the 17,000 domains, I brute forced over 3,000 host names. Found lots of systems, and from these systems, I looked how many unique IPv6 addresses come up. That was something like 15,000. In 7,000 networks, and for that point, forget that. 7,000 networks, which are actually not that many, if you think about that. But not a problem, we come to that. Now, unique host addresses. This is the host part. So if you're an IPv4 address, you have 192.1.1, that would be in a C-class, the network part, and the last .1 or .100 would be the host part, the local host part IP address. And here there would be 5,800 unique host addresses. I said, okay, what can I do there, maybe? This, I made a statistic of all the unique host addresses, how often they will come up. And you see, there is some spike until here, and then it's not very steep. I thought, okay, if I scan all the networks just for the 300, 400 most common addresses, I will find many more systems. Okay, so I did a host address analysis. How are these IPs, two addresses that I found? How can I group them? So first I saw, okay, some are auto-configuration. Some are configured by hand. Some are DHCP, or hand, that's sometimes hard to distinguish. What does that mean? Auto-configuration means it is either done by the MAC address. So if, let's say, some company has only one vendor there, yeah. Most of the MAC address is the same, very easy to scan. Privacy option means it will be random and will be regenerated once a week, for example, depends on the configuration, so not very useful for us. And something like totally random fixed stuff. Yeah, by hand, it's either clear pattern or it was random. And DHCP, DHCP even on IPv6, which is one of the issues, in my opinion, is it hands out the IP address sequential. So if you know the starting point, very easy to enumerate the rest. If you got one, you got all, and it's easy to find. So here, with a MAC address, you have a 24-bit key space per vendor ID, more or less, some or more, it depends on the vendor ID type. This is scannable. Yeah? Privacy option fixer, and of course, this is bad luck. By hand, if it's a pattern, easy. If you see the pattern, done. If the random, of course, doesn't work. And we have DHCP. If you find an address in a DHCP address space, piece of cake. So, and auto-configuration, if they use the MAC address for that, it's also kind of easy. By hand, what are people using there? So this is just the obvious stuff. There are some more, but I wanted to keep the slide somehow simple. Yeah, you have something like 123, or very common is service port, like 80 for the web port, for the web server, 53 for the DNS server, or if they have more DNS servers, this would be 1:53, 2:53, and so on. Or the other way around, first the service port, then counting upwards. Some use even the real IPv4 address, which is okay. And of course, people who like to make some fun with poop babe, dead beef, whatsoever. But these are less common. Then you have the DHCP address space. Actually, this and this is what is in the literature. So this is what you usually find, because people do what's in the literature. Even passwords. I mean, how often you see Cisco as a password on a Cisco router, because it's in the example configuration and documentation and stuff? Works. So also, this is not a very large key space. So all in all, this is auto-configuration. This is the hard DHCP or hand stuff, which are very hard to identify, random privacy stuff, IPv4 addresses. And this is the easy DHCP, easy hand-configured stuff. Yeah? And this is what we can very easily find, but just using basic, regular patterns. How many? Could it be millions? Of course, way less. So I did a live scan on all the found networks. Brute force 3,000 host addresses, the 3,000 host addresses based on this address space. And I found, wow, 380,000 systems alive. That's way more. And so on and so on. How do I find more networks if I can't just scan these networks? How can this be? Because there are lots of routers in between. You say, oh, sorry, this system is not available. And then you have some more networks identified. This is how this works. So this is why more networks are in the output than in the input. Weird, but, well, that's how life is, or IPv6. So, but from the over 3,000 host addresses I tried, only 2,007 were really active. So, and if we look at this graph, oh, this makes sense. So, at this point, this is what we actually have to scan for, because this is what people are actually using. So, to do an effective scan, we just have to scan for about 2,000 IPv6 host addresses, and that's it. And then we will already have, depending on the configuration, between, yeah, on average, 70-80% of the whole IPv6 addresses in a destination network. And this is something you can do in just in a few seconds. I did some reverse DNS entry analysis to see what are the DNS host names people are supplying, to see is this different to IPv4, and what are they using, what are the most common ones, what are the least common ones, so to have an effective word list for that. Did this as well, and here again you see we just need about 1,000, 1,200, 800, in somewhere, wherever you want to put that. These are the active host names people are using. Yeah? And actually, how you work your way is like that. You're doing DNS brute force on stuff you found alive. You get new DNS entries. You put these new DNS entries in the alive scan. You get new alives. The alives you put back in the DNS brute forcing, and so on and so on, until you found all the systems. This is the basic algorithm I did with my research, and how you would do a remote penetration testing. And alone by DNS brute forcing, you will get maybe 90% of the systems, but by systems here I mean servers. Not necessarily routers, because they have